Hello students, today we start our new chapter, that is chapter number 8, introduction of trigonometry. So first of all, let's check what is a trigonometry. Okay, the meaning of trigonometry is, that is the Japanese word, so tri. First, T-R-I, tri means 3. 1, that is side, and metric. It means that trigonometry means you have to measure three sides of measurement. Okay? So you understand what is the meaning of trigonometry? That is the three side measure. So in the triangle, we have to find the measure. Okay? We have to find the side, value of side. So we find out in this chapter introduction to trigonometry. Okay? How we find? Let me check. Okay? Using the formulas, but first of all, you know that what is the meaning of trigonometry? It means three side measurement. Okay, clear? Let's start. Okay, we know that in triangle there is three sides. Okay, now we already learned the Pythagoras theorem in chapter number 6. In that, we know that the two sides and third one is hypotenuse. Now, here we have to find out the measurement of using the angle. First of all, in trigonometry, there is two basic functions are there. First one is sine, second one cos. In these two functions, these two angles, we have to find remaining six angle of trigonometry. Okay, function, function. Total trigonometric function is 6. Basic 2, that is sine and cosine, or its short form is cos. And using that two function, we have to find the other 4. So let's start. First of all, we check the ratio. The sine of angle, here I find out the measurement of sine angle using angle A. So that is it. Now it is hypotenuse, angle B is 90. In triangle ABC, we take in triangle ABC, angle B is 90. Now, we find out the angle A. I want to measure. Okay, why we need to find out this angle? In your textbook, there is a 2-3 examples are that if the kite in the sky, so we have to find the what is the angle in our eye to see the kite. Okay, that is the incident ray, what we need angle. So we need to measure the side. If we know that side measurement, so using this formula, we can find out the angle. Or if we have angle with me, okay, then we find the also side measurement. Okay? So there is a mountain out there. So we can take in a ground that is a 60 degree angle, and the distance is something x. We have to find the height of mountain. So we can find out using the trigonometric functions. Okay, that's why we learn it. First function is sine. So that is the formula, is basic formula. Okay? You have to remember the basic formula, that is sine opposite of angle A upon hypotenuse. Here, BC upon hypotenuse means, that is our first formula. Okay, that is sine, or you can write like this, sine A. Next one, cosine of angle A, that is cos A. Now, formula of cos. That is side adjacent to A. Side adjacent to A. Angle A upon hypotenuse. That is AB upon. Next, tangent of A. tangent. It means tan A. Okay, it is written tangent of A. It means that is the formula of using the already told you that the basic function is sine and cos. Using that two function, we find the remaining four functions. So that is the formula is sine A upon cos A. Okay, so ratio of this one, hypotenuse, hypotenuse cut. So we have side opposite to angle A upon side adjacent to angle A means that BC upon AB. Next, cosine, cosec. Next, fourth one is cosec. It means 1 upon sine. Okay, so it means that is the reciprocal of sine. Reciprocal of sine. It means hypotenuse in numerator and the side hypotenuse means is. Next, sec. Sec is a reciprocal of cos. Sec is a reciprocal of cos. So, next formula is hypotenuse upon side adjacent to angle A. Hypotenuse means AC upon AB. That is the first ratio, second, third, fourth, fifth, and last. That is cotangent. Okay? Our short form is cot A. That is a two formula. Cot means 1 upon 10. Or we can write different code here. 10 is equal to sine upon cos. So denominator of denominator and numerator. It means cos A upon. There is two formula. You have to remember this formula also and this thing. Now, you know that cos means side adjacent to angle A upon hypotenuse. Side opposite to hypotenuse, hypotenuse, hypotenuse cut. Or we can take a reciprocal of tan, that is adjacent in numerator and opposite in denominator. Side adjacent to angle A upon side opposite to angle A. Here, adjacent side means AB upon BC. Okay, so that is the sixth formula. Using this formula, we have to solve the sum. Okay, so I just write here the whole thing. Now I write here short. OS upon height. That is OS means opposite side and hypotenuse means hypotenuse. Okay? Adjacent means AS upon hypotenuse. If you want to remember like this, so you can remember OS upon AS. Then hypotenuse upon cosec means hypotenuse upon OS. Hypotenuse means hypo upon AS. And A is upon last four. Okay, you have to remember all this formula. If you don't want to remember this thing, so you have to go for short. You don't want to remember this size. Okay, either you have to remember this or this. The formula of sine, it is the side opposite to angle upon hypotenuse or opposite upon hypotenuse. Cos, side adjacent to angle upon hypotenuse. Or AS upon hypotenuse. Then sine upon cos or side opposite to side adjacent to angle A. OS upon AS. Cosec 1 upon sine means hypotenuse upon side opposite to angle A. Hypotenuse upon OS. Sec 1 upon cos hypotenuse upon side adjacent to angle A. Hypotenuse upon AS. And last chord is a reciprocal of tan or cos by sine. Side adjacent to side opposite. A is upon plus. Okay. Note down is all this formula. Okay. Now we have wanted to, we have to just change the angle so you can understand why I tell you you have not want to remember this thing. Okay. So first of all, note down this formula. Okay. Then we start for another triangle. Okay. Now we have to learn this thing. Now we start for another angle. Now here we solve this angle A. Now we take angle C. Then so it is the opposite side here. Okay. We know that is a down side, so we go up side. So it become opposite side. To angle C and it become adjacent side to angle C. Okay, adjacent to angle C and hypotenuse remain same. Okay, now here angle C, so I become sine C. So all came become C. Okay, we have find out for sine. Angle C. Now students, let's just check what we have to change. We are only change the angle. No, nothing. Okay. The formula remains same, but side also change. That's it. So sine of angle C. Sine C means sine opposite angle. Opposite angle to C. And upon hypotenuse. Now check what is the opposite side, that is AB, not BC. Okay, if we go for a sine A, then our opposite side is BC. Now if we go for the angle C, then opposite side means that is AB. So here AB upon AC. Okay, if we change the angle, then opposite and adjacent side might be changed. Clear? That's why I told you you don't want to remember sine. You have to just remember the short form or the long form. Okay, this depend on. Now adjacent to angle C. So adjacent side become BC. So BC upon AC. Okay, and now sine opposite to angle A. Opposite side means AB. And opposite means AB, adjacent BC. Hypotenuse cosec C means here also C. Here all angles become C. We are going to find out using the angle C. Okay, now we change here. Now hypotenuse AC is the side opposite. Opposite side means AB. So here it can become AB. AC as it is here, BC. And that thing also change. Adjacent means BC upon AB. Okay, student, so you understood. We don't change the formula. Okay, like adjacent upon hypo, upon opposite upon hypotenuse, we don't change. We have to just change only in side. So you have to, what you have to remember? This formula. Okay, you have to remember this formula. You have to write in your prayer book, and at least 5 times you have to write this formula. Okay, like sine C is equal to opposite upon hypotenuse, cos C is equal to side adjacent upon hypotenuse, or A is upon hypotenuse. Okay, it depends on. Okay, note down first, you note down the first triangle. Now you have what to do? You have to draw another triangle and write all this formula. Okay.